A person standing on top of a bridge 20 feet high throws a ball upward with an initial velocity of 140 feet per second. Assuming the ball is released 6 feet above where the person is standing, find the time it will take for the ball to fall into the river below the bridge. Use the formula h equals negative 1/2 gt squared plus v sub 0 times t plus k. It's always helpful to draw a little diagram of what's happening. So we have a bridge. Here's the land. And the bridge, maybe it looks like this. And it is 20 feet over a flowing river. Okay, this is not a suggestion to throw things off of bridges, but this is the problem. The person throws the projectile, throws the ball from this 20 feet perch, and the person is another 6 feet above the base of the bridge. So that's going to be a total of 26 feet. The ball goes up and then back down. Okay, now let's talk about the variables. What do these variables stand for? Well, the h is height. So that's a good one to know. G equals gravity. And more specifically, it's the acceleration due to gravity. When you're talking in terms of feet per second, then this gravity is going to be 32 feet per second. So in other formulas, you may have seen a 16 right there. That's just the 32 divided by 2, 1/2 of 32. Okay, the V sub zero is the initial velocity. Initial velocity. What is that initial velocity? We are told that it is 140 feet per second. And k is the initial height. So again, the bridge is 20 feet high, and the person releases the ball 6 feet above that. So we know that the initial height is 26 feet. Now we just plug all this stuff in and solve. The h, what are we solving for? When will the, t stands for time, by the way. Time in seconds. Okay, when will it hit the river, fall into the river? That is when h equals 0. Right, assuming this is our 0. Up from there, 26 feet is where the ball is released. Okay, now we just plug everything in. Let's do that. We have 0 equals negative 1/2 times the 32 times the t squared. T is the unknown, plus the initial velocity, which is 140 feet per second, times t, plus that initial height of 26 feet. This is our quadratic equation. We have 0 equals negative 16 t squared plus 140 t plus 26. We have our a, b, and c. A is negative 16, b is 140, c is 26. We're going to plug all of that into the quadratic formula. So x, we're using t here, so let's stay with that variable. T equals negative b, so negative 140, plus or minus the square root of b squared, 140 squared, minus 4 times a, that's negative 16, times c, which is 26. This is all over 2 times a, 2 times negative 16. Okay, we're going to cut to the chase here and simplify all of this that's under the radical. And you'll get a t equals negative 140 plus or minus the square root of 21,264. That is all over negative 32. That's 2 times negative 16. Let's bring it up here to complete this. Negative 140 plus or minus, I'm going to write these two separate things, plus or minus the square root of 21,264. That is 145.822 all over negative 32, or negative 140 minus 145.822. I'll just write the point 8 there just for the space. All divided by negative 32. Those are our two distinct solutions. Simplifying this, we get either negative 0.182 or we get positive 8.932. Okay, why can we throw out this negative? We can throw out the negative because t stands for time. And the ball did not hit the river before the person released it. So we will cross out the negative. In this case, in other word problems, you may not be crossing out the negative, but in this case, we will. It doesn't make sense in this problem. So this would be our answer. So the ball hits the river, or drops into the river, as the question asks, in 8.932 seconds. So just to review, draw a little diagram, make sure you know what the variables stand for, and then plug and chug. And we solved this using the quadratic formula.